Well, welcome back to this new project. It is a grain cart, augered grain cart, and I'm in it. Need some little bit of work done to her, some fabricating and stuff. So I've been working on this for a couple days. Basically what it needs, I got it once I get out of this thing, which is a pain in the ass because I got like 10 inches to squeeze through. But how this thing is, it's not falling. Okay, so this thing has two. Fuck, keep sliding. There's two doors. The one I just got cut out is the bottom. Like clean out door. Or if you have like a grain pit, that's how you would empty into it. So that's supposed to slide back and forth by this rod, but it wasn't working. So after we got it cleaned out and looking at it, this whole chunk is missing. Rusted away. This thing had a hard life. Actually, they beat the shit out of it and didn't maintenance it. But anyhow, so the rod was moving back and forth, but this gate was not, because that chunk was rusted off. So I just got that cut out. Fuck. If you only knew the angle of this, it's retarded. So that's cut out. So it's mostly good. Just needs that. Just need to refab a little piece for that end. That one, which I'll probably cut it in between these and just remake this piece. So, and if I ever get, well, when I get under here, I'll show you what they did. Because right here is where that end was. So when that broke, you should see what they did underneath the plug it up. It's kind of humorous. That thing is fucking awesome. Let's try to get out of this thing without dying. Yeah, cute little steps. Here's how I get out. This is such a pain in the ass. But the shop is never big enough. Now I'm on the outside. You can kind of see what's going on here. Okay. So first got this thing. Oh, in that center bottom, there's supposed to be an auger. That thing was roached. I'm gonna be replacing the flighting on it. The tube's fine, the flighting's just gone. So that's ordered. That'll be another day, another video. But this thing, all the bearings were roached. So we got bearings replaced, all that in. This thing, this is supposed to be the, it's a clutch. So when you're operating it, something jams in there or whatever, this, it slips to save things from grenading. But when we got it, all what they did, the clutches apparently burned out and they didn't feel like replacing them. So they just cinched it metal on metal, which we're assuming is what caused this gear housing to shatter. That's the point of the clutch, is to keep this from happening. So anyway, this I removed earlier. So this sits on top of that plate I just took out. This is the top grain door. Yeah, see that bottom one, that bottom piston, how it's bent? It clearly got fetched up and they just cranked on it and it bent that rod and it totally hosed the cylinder bracket because it's supposed to look like this, nice and straight, and that one is hooped. But anyway, this one is down in here is the auger that is fucked. But that rides underneath this thing. And that top cylinder slides this back and forth so it feeds this auger. Like so. Well, shit. Whatever, you've seen it open. But, got that out. It's a little roached. It ain't bad, though. Pretty much just need to fix the first foot of each end on that inner slide part, and that'll be good to go. It's not bad. Yeah, put this thing in perspective. Fucking huge, but it's actually kind of tiny. This is a small model. Anyhow, your grain comes up. You open up that door, it comes up through there, goes into this transfer spot, and you fold this one on top of that one, and it just augers out, which is nice, but well, that's what I've been doing. So, it's very simple, it's just low effort. There's two pieces of steel that held that piece I'm taking out now in place with the guides. But let's look at their fix after this broke. Might be able to see it. Hang on. Fucking expanding foam and a piece of plywood with metal siding screws or metal roof screws. It's great. But that was their fix. Oh, whatever. But other than a little bit of metal replacement and fab work, this thing will be back on the road shortly. So, the thing, it holds 400 bushel, that's the 400 of whatever, corn, beans, whatever, grain. But, I just now thought to show you guys what I've been doing after I had it all apart, so, maybe I'll reassemble and making all this crap that needs fixed, I'll remember to bring you along. So, well, this has been my project recently, and then this is my neighbor's shop. It's his bin. But, I also put we also put a 540 yoke on instead of a 1000. Yoke, RPM. Let's see, I still gotta press this bearing off of this. But anyway, that's another day. But in my shop, I got another grain wagon. It's a small one though, but I gotta cut out and replace the frame rails on it because it's falling off the running gear. So, well, that's an update on what I've been doing. This big old thing. Oh, Christ, it's huge. Anyhow. Yeah, that's it. I'll keep you posted and bring you along for the rest of the build. Yes, I'll catch you in the next few days or so. And as always, thank you for watching, commenting, subscribing, all that shit. So, later.